would say, "By the time you have finished your food, I will be time for dinner." And when the tortoise was gargling, the hare would say, "By the time you have pulled out those weeds, new ones will have grown in their place."
All the animals in the forest were tired of hearing the hare rapping about his feet, especially the tortoise. So one day, just as the hare was laughing at the tortoise's close weeds, yet again the tortoise answered him back for the very first time.
He said in his slow and steady voice, "All the other animals were astonished, for they knew that the tortoise was the smallest of them all." Here immediately burst into laughter and cried,
"What a joke! That slow coach thinks he can beat me. Right, come on, Mr. Tortoise, I'll show you what my feet are made of. I can beat you before you've even started."
We will see.
The challenge was set and the route was planned.
Early in the morning, the sun came up in the sky. The tortoise and the hare stood at the starting line. All of the animals in the forest stood around to watch the race as the crowd began to count down.
3, 2, 1, go!
Let's beat the hare leapt forward in great bounds, and in no time at all with the plodding tortoise far behind on the dusty road. After a short while, the hare looked behind him. He couldn't see the tortoise anymore.
"I have as good as won this race," the hare thought to himself. "There is no reason to hurry." So as the sun was very warm, he decided to rest under the shade of a tree. "I will finish way ahead of that slow tortoise," he told himself. And very soon the hare was sound asleep, and his little snooze stretched into a good, long nap.
Meanwhile, the tortoise jogged steadily along the wet and dusty road, ever so slowly but surely, until soon he passed the hare, who was still peacefully sleeping. Quickly he floated on towards the end of the race, where all the animals started cheering for him. Quickly, the hare. At that very moment, the hare woke up from his deep sleep with a jolt. He could see the tortoise in front of him, but only a small speck in the distance. Quickly, he jumped to his feet. Without great leaps and bounds, he raced to the finish. But the hare's last leap was too late. The tortoise had won the race!
Slumped down beside the tortoise. "How did you beat me?" asked the hare. "Slow and steady wins the race," said the tortoise. "Slow and steady."
This story might go. This story reminded us of the importance of encouraging each other, and we hope that you too can help to encourage your friends to try new things and remember. Don't give up, especially when you're finding something difficult.
Mm-hmm.
remember, if you work hard and play, you can do it.